Alright, welcome to our third race of the quadruple header. Between Dark Magician, 1184, and Rose City Saint, both fantastic runners. Should be quite the race, as we have already seen from both of our previous races here. So, buckle in, because we've still got a lot more to go. We got one more after this, and then we still got the Angry Larry Buzz Thunder matchup later on over on Digshake's channel. So, lots to go tonight. So right away, we do have a boulder sitting right there out in the middle of the desert as we enter Death Mountain. So if we do see a hammer early, we will probably find these guys making a pretty quick return trip, as that is a very easy item to get a hold of. And we did see a palace there. I did miss which one it was, but I'm sure we'll see Dark Magician jump into it very quickly here in just a second. So we find the start of Jump Cave there. Grass tile for Rose City Saint, which has the horn. Not really what you're looking for early on, but it can make things a little bit easier later on, depending on where that River Devil decides he wants to be. And we do have a palace. It is going to be Palace 1. Dark Magician going to go ahead and peek in here and see what's we got going on. Nice purple color. Kind of matches his name on Twitch, in fact. And unfortunately, Dark Magician taking a death to this Iron Knuckle, but he is going to get a key here for his trouble. So we'll be able to navigate at least a little bit here in P1. A nice 200 experience from the Red Iron Knuckles. So we'll have to keep an eye out to see what those drippers are in Palace 2. If they're Red Iron Knuckles, we might see some grinding. Ugh, immediately followed by a blue. That's always the horrible thing. And it's going to take a second death here very quickly in Palace 1. Always fun having Blue Iron Knuckles guard nice little corridors like this. Unfortunately, going to take another death. I think we'll see DM just back on out here as Rose City making his way towards the same area on the map. Finds an inflatable dig shake. Not super useful, but we do find Medicine Cave on Dark Magician's side, so hopefully something useful in here for him. Nice axe to the head there by the Red Daira. Always fun having those guard the magic, or the medicine cave here. Dark Magician gets a much better rhythm here going, and we'll see if we can get him down. Even with attack too, those guys take it a lot of hits to take down. And it is just a magic container, unfortunately. Gonna go ahead and up an A as we do find the Town of Saria on Rose City Saint's side. We'll see what our first spell of the game is. And and it is the shield spell, so nice to actually have early. Helps to get through some of these harder encounters.
Go close the door. Go.
You will need to watch the video, because it is totally worth watching the VOD for the last race. And the raft in the heart container cave for Dark Magician, so easily gonna be able to move on to the next area here if he wants to go towards the east. Saint gonna pick up the raft as well, so pretty much even here, other than the horn out of the one cave that Dark Magician hasn't found yet. So we do have the grass tile. I'm sorry, this is the peabag cave. I think this peabag cave and the trophy cave are still unfound, so we'll see what's in the peabag cave here. And we do have a magic key find, which is awesome to find early on. Always a great relief off the back to not have to worry about keys or the fairy spell and magic consumption, so good find. Yeah, Cool in the Gank, if you want to jump in, I would be more than happy to help you, or have your help. I am on my third race of four tonight, and my voice is slowly starting to go out. If I could take the Buzz Thunder Angry Larry matchup, I totally would, but it's already spoken for, Buzz. Ah, double Dyra's. What a great encounter this is.
Hey, can you hear me?
Yes, sir. Welcome. Cool on the Gank.
For as far as the timing goes. This, I removed the sound from this one.
Yeah, so Rose City picking up the magic key as well there. So pretty much all bang even, other than the grass tile still not found for Dark Magician, but as you know, the horn is generally not that big of a deal.
Just I missed the beginning, I think they did, right? Sorry, I just couldn't keep track of it.
Yeah, last race came down to AA taking the Eon drop and Eon not taking the Eon drop, and that actually ended up being the difference maker there. AA actually did lead by about 40 seconds going into Grand Palace. He was the first one in. He was the first one to make the choice to actually take the Fairy Cave to find the elusive Peabag Cave. But yeah, he did not hold the lead for very long. And so Rose City is going to find the Medicine Cave as well, which will net him the Magic Container, I believe, that was in here. So we're still missing Trophy Cave.
You're fine, you can hear me, right? Sorry.
I can't hear you, yes.
Yeah, you said you could hear me?
I can indeed.
Yeah.
And a horn pickup for Dark Magician, so just missing Trophy Cave at this point. We might see Dark Magician go back into P1. That blue Iron Knuckle is a little bit of a pain to deal with, but not a lot of options left.
Noticed he went into P1 at first. So we have Palace 1, Great Palace, and is it Palace 3 or 6? I guess we don't know yet on the Western Continent.
That does sound correct, yes. So I'd imagine that we'll see, we've got Rose City going into P1 here. Basically, not a whole lot of options left outside of finding the final cave, which is the Trophy Cave. Maybe they found the Trophy Cave already. I could be... could have missed that, but not a whole lot left other than P1 or heading east. And it looks like we're going to actually dive Death Mountain for Dark Magician.
And it doesn't look like the Western Continent is split into two different sections, right?
There are still a couple of towns that they haven't found, so it could very well be. I think we've...
Okay, so then it is, then.
It could be that one of those towns is just, in a cool little valley like the Peabag Cave last race was. It has happened before. And DM choosing to check out all the... And finds Hammer Cave right away, pretty quick. So, good choice by him. We'll see if this pays off. And Rose City does...
Did he find it in the initial set of caves, or did he have to take a connector? I think he just found it right there, right?
Yeah, it was on the initial set. Pretty large area at that Death Mountain opening, so... we'll see.
Large area with Spectacle Rock.
Good, very good point. Very generous Death Mountain this time around. Meanwhile, Rose City Saint does manage to get past that blue Iron Knuckle and is making some progress here in Palace 1. He does find the item room, and we'll see what this ends up giving him.
Tree. In Life 4. Just pick Life 4.
Yeah. I'm not too up. 3-2-4 is a good place to be if you're Dark Magician without having done a palace.
On the most of the game, I'm with those stats. A hard container.
So yeah, Heart Container out of Death
I'll
Mountain.
I'll wait 3 seconds before talking, then.
Yeah, you're fine. So, no glove, but we do knock out that particular option for Dark Magician, so that is nice to have. We'll see if he goes in here into Palace 1, as Rose City Saint is making pretty good progress thus far, and did find the kit out of there just not too long ago. Thank you. Yeah, so we do see Dark Magician head into P1 here. And Rose City Saint's still working on clearing it up himself. After this, it's pretty much head east. Chat might remind me, I don't think we saw Trophy Cave, but we very well could have, and I just might have missed it. And correct me if I'm wrong, but we've only seen Saria. We haven't seen Raru, Mido, or Raru, or Ruto, so we got fire.
We've only seen Saria. Yeah. That was a shield spell.
Yeah, somebody's saying that fire from the first town, but I don't remember seeing anybody get fire.
Coming up to a horse head now. See that too often. Yeah, he's got the fire spell from
Raru. Okay, I will mark that. I had missed that. I was doing a few tech things, so very good. Do we know what that's linked to yet?
I don't know, and I don't know if he's even tried it. I think it's 55 to cast, so it's very well castable.
Alright, horse head down. He's going to get attack 4 out of this as well, so going to be 4-2-3, finishing up P1. That's a good place to be.
Pay and go east. Yeah, that's all that's left. No downstab, so east with without downstab.
So if we do find the hammer, we've got two quick access accessible caves with the trophy cave and the Death Mountain Boulder just being right out there in the middle. So.
Oh yeah, with a hammer, I fully expect them, if they're still looking for items, to go back and get those two items.
Yeah, just too easy to get, honestly. And there's Saria again for Rose City Saint. We still haven't seen Ruto or Mido, so it'd be interesting here.
Jump cave and. We've seen the beginning of, I believe, a Parappa cave, so there's a potential for connections there. The end of Jump Cave, they could very well try and explore that.
And I don't
remember seeing the entrance.
I don't either, and I don't think Dark Magician has gotten either spell yet either, so...
It was right by the starting, the first palace, the starting point, like North Palace.
Alright, so... Rose City.
Oh, he knows Bagu. Look
yeah.
at that.
I don't know what he found Bagu, but this is a good play. We haven't seen the back end of Saria. This could be a good way to access.
It was in from like a long time ago.
And we have a horse head for Dark Magician.
Part of the Western continent. Have been an alternative. Here's a short cave, see? So I think short cave connects as well as a...
Actually, oh wait, we haven't seen Magic Container Cave. Good point. As Rose City walks in there, so we did have one other cave. We'll see what's in here.
The heart container.
Was it?
I'm sorry. Forgot to wait 3 seconds.
No, you're good. I didn't remember if we had seen it or not, so yeah, another heart container. Actually, I think Dark Magician had already found that, as he has one heart container. So, Parappa Cave was next to the boulder block, so he took Parappa Cave. So, yeah, we're still looking for the two towns. Wonder if it'd be interesting if you have to take the ferry drop yet again to get to those two towns.
You probably introduced the players, but would you agree that they're very similar in their potential?
Oh, yeah, for sure. I mean, Dark Magician's played this a little bit more, I think, than Rose City Saint has, but... Rose City Saint has been a extremely competent player at this ever since he started. So I would put these guys very evenly matched, which has been kind of the story for all of our matches today, I think. And Dark Magician does go back in and does pick up the kit, so we're all even on that front. Just at this point, I think gonna have to head east.
That kid's parents didn't tell him that he found him.
And there is one more town up here north that Rose City's gonna check, and then the raft spot right by
Rideau. No, it's
yeah, that's Rideau. And Mido right down there by it, so good place for both of these towns to be.
That's pretty good, seeing if they find ferry or jump, they can easily go back using the raft, get the downstep, then go back east.
Yeah, for sure.
No need to up A.
Yeah, east without downstep is
in Death Valley.
Rough. I don't think he has.
I don't think Madagascar Dave is asking if he cast fire. I don't think he checked what it is linked to.
Which is interesting because
I was trying to get my microphone to work.
It's only 55 to cast, and having if he didn't check it, and it is fairy or jump, that is, I don't know, pretty interesting of a choice, honestly. As we see 3 or 6 and Palace 4 pretty quick on the Eastern Continent as well.
Maybe just hunting for the glove, you know, and there's some overlap there, so as long as he priorities finding the glove, and then maybe he'll and see if he needs a spell item.
Yeah, that's true. And VOD right here as well, so a lot of stuff clustered together.
Yeah, it's very rare.
Take Parappa Cave here for Dark Magician, which gets him. Well, that's way down south. That's not really where he wants to be, I don't think.
Pea bags. And there you go, there's 501.
Yeah, and we got Dark Magician diving into 3 or 6 here as we see the water tile. And this is going to be Dungeon Palace 6. He'll just up and out.
3 or 6, depending on the.
With that that room with the key, the way that it was, it's Palace 6 for sure.
Okay, so 3 was on the three was on the west end.
And back to Death Mountain. He's trying to figure out where to go here. And definitely have to get north to go anywhere else.
Nick.
Yeah, I'm not honestly sure where Raru is. I don't believe Dark Magician's found it, so it'd be interesting to see if he locates that.
Dinner for a sixth one.
Yeah.
You can call it a freebie. Here.
Pretty, actually, not a terrible find, honestly. Could be worse. Magician is going to find Raru, so he will pick up the fire spell as well. Maybe we'll see what this is.
Right.
That's the spell.
And the reflect.
Yeah, reflect spell out of Nukasudo, so great find there.
Be synced.
And it's castable.
He cast fire, didn't he? But it didn't do anything. So it might be
life reflect, spell, or thunder.
And what I like to do is find an enemy, a screen with enemies, and cast it. And then if anything happens, it's life or reflect.
wasn't Spell, because I think we just saw him, Rose City, go check.
You know what? I think it's Reflect.
Yeah, it looks like it might be. Has to be. As we do find a P-Bag cave here on the Eastern Continent for Rose City Saint.
Spell was so easy to find that it's very much a, you know, a small difference at this point.
And another magic container, so three magic containers for Rose City Saint very early on.
Cave now.
Now see, so we'll need to see what Dark Magician's move is. He's still trying to figure out where the heck he needs to go.
Cave.
And having the horn actually allows us to bypass the River Devil here, so saving perhaps the trouble of dealing with a pass-through cave could be very beneficial.
I don't think that Bagu was required. I do think that maybe the short cave was what they call the Parappa cave might have been one way to get to the north.
Yeah, it would be, I think so. It could be. I don't know, I didn't pay a whole lot of attention, to be honest. I don't know all the back caves too well. But yeah, I mean, if it does happen to be Bagu, then that's interesting. If it is Bagu required, then that's a little bit rough. We have seen before, finding Bagu can take a lot of time and can cost you quite a bit in a race like this.
Yeah. Where he was in a secluded area.
Yeah, I think Madagascar Dave is correct in that I believe Dark Magician took Short Cave, and it actually took him down to the southern portion of the western continent, so it didn't actually take him north.
He found Bagu. Well, yeah, I'm curious, you know.
Yeah, I think it is a Bagu required seed, which is pretty rare, actually. But has given you know, Rose City a bit of a exploration lead. I would say probably 5 to 10 minutes at this point, unfortunately, just due to. Him already having found Bagu and kind of put the pieces together a little bit quicker. And Rose City Saint does find Daburu, so we'll see what spell he ends up finding here. The fairy spell.
He's gonna go back and get downstabbed, I bet.
That's a tough call, but he's gonna do it.
Up 8, I'm assuming he was far from the wrath spot.
Yeah, he was quite a bit.
Because it was right there.
He's actually gonna take. I was gonna say, that's the fairy cave, but he's not gonna go that way. Have the magic container cave and a heart container pickup for Dark Magician. So I guess, yeah, the heart container that he had got previously was from the Death Mountain Hammer Cave. That's right. Yeah, bad boot required. Pretty awesome. There's been one little thing in each of the seeds tonight that's been a little bit different from most seeds. It's been quite enjoyable to watch.
Yeah, it is Bagu required. I loaded up the seed and I tried it myself. And...
Nice. Yeah, so Rose City Sink. I'm gonna go ahead, get back to Mito. I'm gonna pick up Downstab. Got some palaces right there at the start if he wants to
just can't get up there. He did that thing where he you cross and he could just cast fairy and it would probably go faster.
Yeah, that's true. Not something you always think about though.
No, but I think I might have done it. I thought of that after. Why didn't I just cast fairy? I watched that bridge building animation. Nah.
So Dark Magician gonna take his first steps on the Eastern Continent.
I have to say that Rose City Saint is slightly in the lead with one palace down and Downstab, and but at this point anything goes. We don't even know where the glove is.
Yeah, the glove or thunder, so plenty of variables left to play spoiler, but Rose City Saint definitely has what I would say the bit of an early lead, and he can come right back to the Eastern Continent and do Palace 4 as well, as he has Reflect and Downstab as well as the Key and Fairy, so he's got everything he'll need. He can start knocking out some of these palaces, even if he hasn't found all the P-Bag Caves and such.
Or, that definitely sounds appealing, you know, being able to get the item, which is usually a quick find, and then just... same time. I think we've seen Maze Island either, right? Askar Dave calls it an early lead. It's definitely an early lead. We said he's, you know, deciding to go into four, and gonna try and clear it. Most likely get the item because we don't even know if Thunder is a spell item required, and he doesn't have the glove.
Yeah, it would make a lot of sense to look for the item here.
Three and four and six, where you just have to keep going right, and unless if I find the item room, I just grab it and leave. Not the boss, that's fine, you know.
Yeah, and Dark Magician finding new Kasudo, so he's gonna get all the same goodies here that Rose City Saint did.
There's a dead end. Somebody's in chat is asking what the glove does. The glove breaks the bricks, a certain type of bricks. On Rose City Saint's screen right now. Upstab helps you break the bricks that are above from you, and downstab helps you break the bricks that are down from you.
So, running out of options here for which direction to go. We should be seeing either the item room or K-Rock very soon.
Maze Island's got two items we haven't seen yet.
That is very true as well.
And then finding the hammer in would mean that there's two more items that are easy to get.
And the last dead end here for Rosity Saints, so...
Yeah, there's three like that, right?
Yeah, and I believe that is the third one. We're gonna have the dual Crumble Bridges. This should lead either to an item or to K-Rock, one of the two. There is the third one, never mind. I thought he had found them all, so yeah. Back down the elevator, we must go. And I think that, if I remember the layout of Fora, it's going to leave, the two drop locations, the one that's in the middle and then the bottom with the Crumble Bridge.
Comes a skill that you develop as you start running the randomizer. Takes a death to a combination of Doomknocker and that very annoying enemy.
Yeah, the tin suits, those are always great. Doomknockers are the worst thing in the world, next to the Doomrattlers. And we do have the item room here, so... Oh man, what a horrible, horrible room.
God.
Double Doomknocker.
And whoever decided that those hammers were gonna move back, right? Like a boomerang?
Yeah. Alright, he's gonna shield and then try to get through this room. Oh, what a horrible room. And it's actually the last magic jar.
Container.
Oh, that's terrible.
Yeah.
He's trying to decide what to do here. He is going to ferry on through.
Could have been Carrick, but...
As I say, he's got to up A, because at this point, I think he's got to start taking the drops. It's a shame to lose all the experience, but it's quite a bit of backtrack to do otherwise.
When you have those stats like 4-3 and 4 to just like... dump experience and then just rely on palace gems to level up, and it's a very safe strategy.
For sure. All right, Dark Magician going to find another spell here, and it will be Fairy. So he is slowly catching up here.
Keep in mind that Dark Magician still has to go through 4, and I would say that the Rose City Saint's probably almost finished.
Yeah, and also has to go back for downstep, so quite a bit of time still sitting
around. He hasn't done that yet. I totally forgot that.
Yeah, so we should get to the bottom of the Crumble Bridge, and this should be K-Rock.
This has got to be, this has got to be Carrick.
P-Bag K for Dark Magician. A little bit of skipping on Rose City's side, so...
Got a good supply of lives.
Ooh!
So...
Glove for Dark Magician in the Eastern P-Bag Cave.
I didn't really expect to see it in the P-Bag Cave, but we've seen it in previous seasons.
didn't quite see where he was when he got that either, so...
Saint is the type of player that's gonna clear out all the P-Bag caves. This is, of the two P-Bag caves in the east, that this is what I think people consider the hard one, because it's got a... Are they called MOAs? I think they're called MOAs, right?
Blue MOAs. They're lots of fun.
You can take Fairy through that cave, but you'll still probably hit it at least once, because you're going up and down screen.
So nice find there for Dark Magician. Should hopefully find Maze Island here pretty soon as well. But it's gonna get dead-ended down here.
For the glove, then he might lose some time if he hasn't found that P-Bag cave yet. Difficult to navigate.
Okay, I thought we lost Dark Magician for a second, but I think he was paused. And actually, we're gonna find, he's gonna find that glove really quick. Kind of interesting that he had been to Nibiru and got Fairy, but did not actually see this cave down
next
here.
Cave.
So he will find it now, and we'll find the glove.
Yeah, he's got it.
So
he
still
might find that more before he finds the glove. No, he didn't hit any anything.
Still a bit of a lead here for Rose City Saint, having Palace 4 finished. Still looking for Thunder, so that could play a factor on whether or not Dark Magician maybe hunts out that item in Palace 4, which is a bit of out of the way compared to K-Rock, so could make up some time there. Looks like Dark Magician is opting to take a pass through cave here without downstab, and having a blue Zalphos is always a grand old time.
Oh, Rose City Saint and Dark Magician are both 1-1-0, so they both, with a win, they guarantee a place in the race.
That is correct, yeah.
For the brackets. We haven't seen Kasuto yet, right? Thunder might be in its original location.
Yes, we have not seen old Kasuto, that is correct. I think we've seen Darunia. No, we haven't seen Darunia, because both of them have had the kid and have not turned it in, so we're missing Darunia and old Kasuto thus far.
My priority would probably be to find those towns before I further, just to try and figure out if Thunder requires an item or not. Next to each other. He went in. Dark Magician went in, old Kasuto just went out. I think he was afraid to hit Moa and take a death. Oh. Promises to call back in the morning. Life, and he was afraid to take a death in old Kasuto. And that's a very legitimate reason for going to check. Oh wait, does he not have the child? Oh no, he wants to get a refill of magic. Out. We're gonna find out if it's Thunder or Life. Jump.
Yeah, worst case scenario here would be jump. Anything else would probably be okay at this point. Spell, obviously, not the greatest thing, but it could lead to the spell item for Thunder. And it is the life spell, so... Wow, what a swamp for Rose City Saint here.
Nice refill. He's going to go into Old Kasuto and...
And Maze Island right there as well.
Where the Moa was.
Nice job hitting three times. Very nice.
Yeah. So, item needed for Thunder?
Yes, indeed.
We're going to see him go in Maze Island and try and get a spell item, most likely. To New Kasuto and get that the item in the Tower of World.
And meanwhile, Rose City Saint has found an area that he hasn't been before, but it does lead to Valley of Death, actually, which is quite interesting. So he does know the way there, but it's just right over here by where Dark Magician
Old Kasuto and Darunia.
So yeah, we're right in the same area again. Pretty much.
He's gonna find out that he needs an item for Thunder.
I mean, outside of the Palace 4 advantage for Rose City Saint, we're dead even, so it's pretty crazy. And I don't think Dark Magician's gotten downstabbed yet either.
Around and finds the boots, which is gonna help a lot to clear Maze Island. And navigate the world in general.
Yeah, boots.
Water tile
great
back
point.
There. Love that screen. Tough doing Maze Island without downstab. I know I have a hard time doing that. A lot though. I would be casting it on every screen if I had magic. Downright brutal. Loses his Alphos. Be a real pain in the neck. So I think he's dead. You know, he's set on upgrading his life. Palace 2 without knowing what the other Maze Island item is. Probably finished looking at Maze Island. I find Palace 2 is a bit on the long side. I feel it's longer than 3. Instead of right, so that takes quite a bit of time. So just finding the item out of there. That screen that's kind of fairy blocked, where you have to do the good side of that screen. Keys at this point. I think he's just maybe he. I don't think he has the master key, so I think he can. He feels confident that he can just fairy through doors at this point with 7 magic containers. 500 from that, He says they both have the master key. Thanks a lot for that information. That explains why he's been skipping all his keys. Plus, I haven't seen him go left once, but maybe he hasn't had the chance to go left. Also in Palace 2. He's a little bit behind. Reaper's drop? I don't think so. Sometimes it can be a nice surprise. It could be a blue hit. Is you 200? We're coming up on Midhead here. Get the item out, or just keep exploring Maze Island, maybe.
Alright, my apologies. I am back. What did I miss?
Palace 2, and I think, so yeah, Dark Magician just cleared Palace 2. Rose City Saints probably gonna clear it. I don't think, yeah, he's going back to look for the item in 2, without knowing what the second Maze Island item is.
Interesting. We'll see what Rose City Saint does, what his choice will be in this case. He is going to get attack 6, so he's going to be a little bit ahead, but he has finished an extra palace as well, so we should be pretty much even on levels, and just that one palace advantage holding on for Rose City Saint here.
Attack 6 for Rose City Saint, and life 6 for Dark Magician. Some very different leveling strategies here at play. To favor the style of taking damage, but I would life 6, I don't blame him.
Yeah, and gonna go back for the item as well, so both making the same call here.
I'm afraid to have to come back and do this all over again. And I'm not sure, but I think from the configuration, it looks like all the left ways were near the boss, so maybe that's a... The initial entry to the palace was very linear. See, it's right in that elevator shaft. All the left and left side corridors are all there. We're gonna do an exploring. I'm not sure why he's going right here.
That's a good question. Well, this is unexplored territory for Rose City Saint. It has not been this direction, and we can tell by the key door, so... we'll see if this goes the right way or not.
Not like he needs the key. Stalfos from the drops.
And it is a dead end that way, so...
I'm really not sure why he went there.
Yeah, quite curious. Maybe he just thought that there was perhaps an elevator that he missed or something, but it is pretty curious.
Sometimes in the tournament, I make decisions like that just because I'm nervous or edgy, you know. And everybody knows that I'm I'm nervous or something with that. Nobody really... Sometimes you just do things. Great find. You're gonna want to cash it in and find out if it's a thunder spell eventually.
Was that the trophy?
Yeah, that was a trophy in two.
Alright. Yeah, at some point he's gonna have to go back across the Great Sea to get Downstab. But it's definitely gonna do the smart move and find the items here. And Rose City Saint, he did not find the trophy. He bailed out of two. We'll see if that actually...
Well, he's still looking for an item.
He does find the boots.
But I'm not sure what he's looking for. He's got the trophy. He maybe wants the medicine as a...
Oh, for sure. I mean, if you've got an item left here, it could be the medicine. This is the easiest place to look for it. However, we'll see if not getting the trophy out of two ends up costing Rose City Saint a lot of time, as that could be a problem if it is the Thunder Spell.
Where is that other item? To look. There it is.
Just a heart container. That's unfortunate.
Knowing that, Rudo and, Trophy town is right next to each other. I downstab and just cash in the trophy. List five. I think it is. I think that's a good decision, knowing you don't need glove. What if medicine is needed and it's in five and he has to go back?
Yeah, I mean, definitely not a bad move. Why backtrack if you don't need to, right? I mean, we saw last seed Nirimbu five palaces without downstab, so it is definitely doable.
Yeah. Wow, what a short palace five.
Holy mama!
Find the item. I think he's gonna bail right out of there. And save 10 minutes.
Love it. Short P5s. Meanwhile, Rose City Saint is in Palace 6.
Yeah, he decided to go in Palace 6. Five. That might
down.
Be on the low end of the experience scale for Guma.
300 is, I believe, minimum. Maybe 200, but yeah, it's pretty close.
So I think he's probably gonna just take the experience levels as they come.
And just bail on out. Good call. Now, item room here in 6 already.
OCD saying holding out for attack 7.
Ooh, 50 P-Bag. What a find.
Yeah. Paid as you would after the Valley of Death, and the old Bagu Pass. Now we're gonna see if he casts Fairy or if he Asian. And there you go, he casts Fairy, but the screen too early. All part of the plan, right?
Yeah, he's been a little bit
casts
cheeky.
Fairy twice. Yeah. Magic refill.
No, it is actually a Bagu. It is a Bagu required seed, Scorpion Max. There is no way to get through to the rest of Western Hyrule without going through Saria. Unless the boots, now that they have that, allow you to get up there. I don't know. That's a good question. I don't know if they've checked.
They might. That's something I haven't checked. Yeah, it was Saria, but... deciding that he likes being a fairy better. He just went through the whole first screen of that town as a fairy.
Ah, only the jump spell. So we need the Water of Life.
It's gonna be... a long seed style that we haven't checked. We still have those two items that are rock blocked, so the hammer might come into play.
For sure. Yeah.
What's up with the fairy? What's up with casting fairy in there?
So finally downstab for Dark Magician. I'm sure he will be very happy to have gotten that.
That desert encounter was brutal. When I was testing out the seed earlier to check if that jump cave goes to that area, and that's the first thing that I met. Daira's there's one orange Daira in there. There's a Northern Palace in a pretty brutal. Palace 6.
Yeah, and Rosity Saint was in there for just a moment. Looks like he bailed out.
Yeah, but he might have been. Maybe was just looking for the item. The ferry is way across this area.
We have a very, very close race here.
Yeah. No, it's getting closer and closer.
I mean, we know that...
His item block is definitely a factor in the...
Oh, for sure. And I mean, we know that, that 5 is really not of any consequence, as getting to Guma is incredibly simple. So, yeah, it's pretty interesting.
Water styles a pee bag.
Ugh.
Sounds like it's gonna be, looking through palaces. It might be in Palace 5. The hammer might be in Palace 5, and then you have to go and check those rocks.
So Sarucity's saying gonna dive into Palace 3 here. As Dark Magician is going to find the item room, and it's going to be very disappointed.
Item room in 3 is usually quick to find. So Rosity Saint doing this very very sound thing here.
Yeah, and he should be able to pretty easily complete this palace as well, so you know he needs to do that anyway, so might as well jump in.
The point P bag we were talking about earlier. Less experience than for the item. Doesn't complete the kill. And there you just wait for them to jump up and disappear into nothingness.
Yep, good old Doom Knockers. Gotta enjoy their mechanics sometimes. It's quite interesting though that Rosetti Saint decided to not finish Palace 6 while in there. He's going to have to take the time to go back at some point.
Of course, Jeffy says if they weren't salted before, they are now. I'm not sure if he's talking about the players or some peanuts.
Oh god, and the cross and P3. P5. What if it's P5?
Very well be P5. Or P5 for Hammer.
I think at this point it has to be. We've seen both. Are we still missing one P-Bag cave on the Eastern Continent? The one with the down steps, maybe?
Saw both of them. I do believe we saw both of them.
Okay, and we have seen the desert tile as well, yes?
That one's so quick, I usually miss it, so...
Yeah, I mean, at best, I think
I would assume that they would find that before they start diving into palaces, both of them, right?
Yeah, and I don't... we haven't seen the Duke of Sudo spell item, have we? I apologize, I've been in and out a little bit on this one. Yeah, so not a lot of options left.
I don't think we've seen the new Kasuto item.
Yeah, the spell item, I think we've still got that available for sure.
Palace 5, especially that short.
We should be seeing a Barba here very quickly for Dark Magician. Very low EXP from the Revenax as well. City should be finding Rebo pretty soon. And does on the next screen. Just as Dark Magician finds Barba, so synchronized bosses here.
Tried to jackhammer, I think he missed, maybe he's just trying to jump, Barba.
I think he's jumping just a tad bit too late.
Yeah. Because he, fire spell.
And 7-3-4 for Rose City Saint after Palace 3, so leveling plan going all as people would normally want it.
Yep. Oh. Ideally, you'd want to take attack 8 and then dump all the leftover into, not take attack 9, but dump everything in life, probably life, and then a bit of magic.
Yes, for sure. Meanwhile, 5-6-6 for Dark Magician. Which he'll be fine as well. He'll at least have attack 6 and probably life 7, so he'll be pretty well set for GP as well. Meanwhile, Rose City Saint is back at New Kasuto. Hoping and praying. And it's the hammer!
That's it. He's going back and he's going to take those two items that are hammer blocked, and we know they are. One is right next to the star, the North Palace, so he's going to do that first.
Heck yeah.
Death Mountain. Don't go there.
Well, at least it wasn't in 5. Heart container, so
Technical
double heart containers.
Is a heart container.
Ugh.
Hammer block cave.
Is he gonna search the rest without going to trophy cave?
You know what? He's gonna find a hammer cave really quick. I think he doesn't want to explore. He just wants to check if hammer cave is not near the entrance.
Yeah, and it's just right up here, so he is going to find it.
Yeah. But we know it's not medicine, so.
Yeah, it is a heart container. So we're gonna have full magic, full heart containers. And once again, searching for that
elusive
spell
a very
item.
Expressive player. He's, you know, he's got the, almost a poker face on. I can't tell what he's thinking at all, just looking at his,
Yeah, he is a very calm player. There are times when he will, let out a little bit of frustration, but for the most part, he's pretty stoic.
His expressions. Oh, now he's pissed. I think we started really, his poker face is a bit.
Yeah, but he's gotta know that there's that one cave left, so yeah. He still has one chance. If not, I'd be curious to see if he goes, and goes back to 2, or if he'll just try to see that if he can find the item in 5, as I'm pretty sure that's about all he's got left.
I'd do P2, probably. P5 is just way out there.
Yeah, but he hasn't finished Palace 5 yet, so he can kind of double dip. And hopefully the medicine will be in here and it won't matter.
Oh, especially with such a short P5.
Oh, man.
Folks, we're in for a P5.
Indeed. Yeah, so I believe that narrows it down, that P5 5 does indeed have the Water of Life.
Hammer, just like Sports Jeffy mentioned, it's just a red herring at this point, you know?
Yeah. Actually, a major time loss, because you up an A out of the Eastern Continent, and you have to go back through Saria and do all that jazz to do it, to get back there again, and then on top of it, to turn in the medicine, you're going to have to do it all over again. So, it's a bit of a time loss.
Knowing that they both have to go back to P5. I mean, Rose City Saint hasn't been yet, but Dark Magician. Trying to clear it. Back east. Room with two Doom Knockers for the item.
And a blue iron knuckle for fun. And gonna find that last magic container. I'm sure that's exactly what he was looking for.
Gonna up in, go and find Karak and take him out. Keep exploring. City Saint seems to know where he's going. He knows the way around connector caves. He knows this cave's probably going to lead him to that area below with the Runio and the Old Kasudo. Which is the southeast section of it takes another, I think it maybe takes another connector cave. He's just gonna use the boots at this point. The boots won't make it there though.
Yeah, you definitely have
to
take a connector. Lost.
I hate when they put a blue Lizalfo in this. You get that downstab over it. They usually use thunder or something.
So yeah, after all this, Dark Magician has kind of pulled himself into the lead. Only has Hal's 3 left. Already has 6 done. I just found Trophy as well. So, I mean, outside of finding the hammer in 3, which we'll have to assume he's going to go check those other caves. Kind of ahead.
Hammer would put him in the lead, because we know he's going to waste time. Again. Nice. There.
All right, crosses in 3, that's right. Hammer was in New Kasudo.
It's Valley of Death for Rosie Saint. Uh, Higinos?
Yeah.
A little exhausted?
Just a little bit, but I'll be alright.
I saw the end of the second one, but were they as long as this one?
No, they were actually pretty short. Honestly, it's just after you have three seeds, everything starts to blend together a little bit.
Oh, that's what I get when I over practice. I get confused. Oh, that's right. I have down stab.
Right? Yeah.
Oh, that's right. I have the boots.
Or key, or something really important, you know, that you don't remember that you've got, that kind of makes a difference. Attack 6 here for Dark Magician, so he's going to be pretty well set at 6-6-7 going into Green Palace. Going to be really disappointed finding the cross here, though. Alright, so P5 for Rose City Saint. He looks like he's actually item searching, so we'll see if that... it should be here for the Water of Light, if I remember correctly. Because we did see the item in 2 from Dark Magician, correct? Correct, Yunos. It's the Water of Life, and the last item that's going to be found. All with a, right, item in 2 was the trophy, that is correct. It's on the tracker, all I have to do is read it. All with a Bagu required Surya pass through.
Yeah.
In order
right,
to get back.
Not forget this Bagu required.
Yeah, it's a lot of time lost every single time that you have to up an A. The only thing that we might have missed would be the desert tile, but I believe somebody said it was a pee bag. So, if that is the case,
I saw a Rose City Saint going back to the desert tile, maybe to avoid an encounter, and it was empty, so they had taken it already.
All right, so definitely 5. So Rose City Saint making the correct choice here, even though he hasn't gotten the item out of 2, it'll be the correct choice. The real question will be. At this point, he's got to know that the trophy or the medicine is an either-or. So will we see him go back to 2 to get that item before up and A, so that way he doesn't have to spend the time to do all this again? That's the real question. As Dark Magician finishes up P3, he's got them all done, but does not have the key Thunder Spell. And for as easy as Guma was to find, this item is definitely not being his kind.
People hoping for a short seed are disappointed. It had all the makings of a short seed with some right in the really short P5, but...
Well, to be fair, we're only an hour 23 in, and these guys have nearly 100% in the seed, so we're still doing pretty good.
I think that speaks for the skill level of those guys.
Most definitely. Especially, like, again, if you consider how many times they've had to up an A and then go back through Surya and make that whole trek just to get to the raft spot, it's, you know, they probably lost 5 minutes to that alone. Dark Magician going to find the hammer here. And again, you gotta assume that he's gonna up an A.
Raft is probably falling apart at this point.
Don't do it yet! Okay. I was really concerned for a moment. That would have been horrible if he up an A'd without actually grabbing it. So gonna get the heart container and the pee bag. Not gonna be happy about it. Unfortunately, we do not have a camera for Dark Magician today.
probably missing out on a lot of frustrated facial expressions. But we've seen them on Rogue City Saints' face, so we'll do that.
Yeah, the one when we get the P-Bag here is going to be the icing on the cake. Rose City Saint going back in, finds a bunch of dead ends. He's going to try to take a different path this time around.
If I'm from Hawaii, you know, I'm French-Canadian, so I'm French and Canadian, so yeah, so I fall in the Canadian hole and I'm crap in bed. I'm best of both worlds.
Looks like Dark Magician may have forgotten where this boulder-blocked cave is at. Time here.
Finally have the item.
Wah! And it is the water of life.
He has to go back and beat Barba as well.
Indeed he does.
Remember, he didn't finish that palace.
Yeah, but fortunately for him, it's a right and he's there. So all he's gonna do is go right, which he's gonna do, and he'll find Barba very quickly. Which I'm sure he will be happy to have happen after the ridiculous palace it was to find the item. And he's got to go back and finish Palace 6. Again, I'll be very curious to see what his option here that he makes is going to be. Gotta hope for some good experience from Barba, but we know it's 300, so he's not gonna actually get that next level, but he should be able to complete what he needs in 6 to get those last life levels that he's gonna want.
Am I right?
Yeah, Guma. I mean Guma, thank you. But man, telling you, I'm tired.
But we do believe that he has to go back and beat Barba, and that's the reason for the confusion.
Indeed. Again, I'm curious if he's gonna go to 2.
He's gonna eat that, probably eat that gem, and then experience in 6. And maybe you just said the same thing, and I'm just repeating what you said, just because I'm not paying attention.
yeah, he's gonna skip it.
Gonna skip it.
All right. Well, wise choice by him, even though he doesn't realize it. Risky though. I mean, you know that the trophy's in 2 and that the 2 is right there. Man, but making the wise play. Meanwhile, Dark Magician trying to get back over to 5, it looks like. Or no, he's trying to find this boulder-blocked cave still. Dang.
Did you see the end of Error and Max's match yesterday? Or maybe you were hosting it? I'm not sure.
I was hosting it, yeah. I was, man. Telling you, that was one of those ones where at 40 minutes, I really thought it was over, and then all of a sudden, 6 was fairy blocked, and you're like, well, we got a game.
Did you see Eric eating those gems?
Oh,
like,
yeah.
He was up-aiding.
Didn't care. Saved himself almost a minute, too, probably, about 45 seconds from doing it.
I'm so close to coming back, it's scary.
Yeah, unfortunately, just, I mean, both guys made some mistakes, right? Scorpion Max went back into 3. Aaron made some mistakes in 2 and some things like that. But regardless, the end of that match was phenomenal. And again, though Error is 2-1, he would be one of the very few people that I would ever think that I could beat. He is a scary opponent. Because not only is
he up against him in round 1, and I came 3 minutes short, and I made a decision to grind a little before Great Palace. And what was I thinking grinding while he's probably eating gems and doing all kinds of stuff to finish as fast as possible?
Yeah. And, you know, the funny thing is that that race against you was, his, I believe, his first 3.0 match that he'd ever played. He is so good at just jumping into a randomizer and being like, I suck at this, and I get, like, you know, second or third place or something. He just, his, you know, his skills from the vanilla game definitely carry over as well.
Jay Cooper is asking what that third spell is. Yeah, it's Thunder. They need Thunder and Medicine Block. Medicine was in D5. And it really is a full clear because he's got all the magic containers and he's got all the, they both have all the left.
Yeah, the only thing he's not going to get will be Jump, which is the trophy at 2.
The hammer was a nice tease there.
Oh, yeah, and it cost Dark Magician, like, over 5 minutes because he couldn't find that cave that had a pee bag. Very unfortunate. Yes, he did. I just marked it. Yes, Jay Cooper. I mean, Rose City Saints still got to finish 6. And Dark Magician knows at this point that Palace 5 contains the medicine, as that is the only thing he has not cleared. So he's got to go back to Palace 5, which is a bit of a trek, and through Valley of Death, and then has to figure out where it is, because Guma was just 2 screens right from start. So that's basically what he did. He's only explored 2 rooms of Palace 5. Meanwhile, Rose City Saint has found the item in 6, but never found Barba.
I don't know how you keep track of all this at your third race. It's unbelievable. You must have a...
Yet when I do my own races, I can't remember where anything is. It's pretty amazing. I honestly think like this would be almost dead even right now as far as...
Supersonic memory.
If, you know, Dark Magician had remembered where that where the trophy cave was, he spent literally 5 minutes running around the western portion of Hyrule looking for it, and lost a lot of time because of it.
The one that was hammer-blocked?
Yeah, the trophy cave was the one that was hammer-blocked, yeah. Just super unfortunate. Rose City Saint does get his experience to make sure that he can get attack 8, so definitely going to be able to at least get life 7. Maybe life 8 if he gets some nice rolls on the levels there, but very well set up for GP.
Yeah, the first caves and the villages when you start a seed is so crucial. Sometimes to practice, I don't do a full seed. What I do is I'll just do the first 30 minutes of a seed. I'll try and map out the west properly, just because it's so important. And what the 5 items are and the 4 towns where they are. And then when I get the raft, I usually I'll just try another seed. Just because remembering where that mountain is, it's so overlooked sometimes. You're like, oh, I probably won't have to come back here. And then you forget where it is and you end up looking for it and not being able to find it.
Yeah, for sure. I just basically get a piece of copy paper now and kind of divide it in half. And, you know, I'll just write an S and an R for the raft spot and the start location. And I'll just write a general location on the paper of where I think it is. You know, if I take a pass through cave, I'll write pass, I'll write a circle, and I'll draw an arrow to somewhere else. That way I can keep track of everything and where it's at, because it has happened several times, and it, you know, while it takes some time to map, if you don't have the memory to remember those things in the long run, it can really save you a lot of time.
It's just a little too much for remembering everything, unless you have a really good memory. For me, I can't remember two continents and blocked caves are. And...
Right, well, and then Death Mountain, if you gotta go through Death Mountain and the procedure for that, and all sorts of junk, man. It's crazy.
Yeah, alright, if I see that the Spectacle Rock is near the entrance, I write like I put a circle next to Death Mountain just so I know this entrance is near the rock, you know?
Yeah, I'll do the same thing for sure. I mean, that's not even taking into account palaces. If you gotta go into 5 or 6 or something like that to find an item and then leave and then try to remember where you've been and what you've done, it's there's a lot to remember.
Do a note where Valley of Death is. I need to find a notation for that. It used to be always Great Palace, but with 3.0, you never know what you're gonna get, so... Barba, right there.
Yeah, Barba down, so... Vantage Rusty Saint.
Is west. It's right next to Palace 1. And it's right next to the raft spot, I believe. No, it's not. It's in the lower part of the western continent. It's, I think, north of the start. North of North Palace. North anymore, but it's still being called North Palace.
Really nice, levels rolls there, so he's gonna get 757. And actually, might actually get a level up on magic and GP if he wants it.
Is he? What's he doing? Okay, so he just cleared 6. Yeah, he's probably gonna level up because he doesn't have to up A. Dump the experience.
Yet another dead end for Dark Magician, unfortunately. That is
how close
one.
Dark Magician is to him. He doesn't know. He might be right on his heels, so he doesn't want to take any chances.
And another dead end for Dark Magician. .37-35, the force field goes up. What on earth? Oh, he up an 8. Okay, I was like, what is he doing? But that makes sense. He's at the end of a long series of rooms that go nowhere. So we'll see how much of an advantage Dark Magician, or Rosity Saint has here. And how much of a difference looking for that hammer cave. Hammerblock Cave actually will make in the end.
Right, we'll be able to tell by the time difference. Second elevator screen, I believe, and then it's a dead end, so he's gonna go up the elevator and right.
And T-Bird.
Very well could be a long palace after T-Bird, seeing that he's that early in the palace, and we haven't seen any drops yet.
Yeah, I mean, I asked this question to everybody, but what are your thoughts on that? Would you prefer having a late T-Bird or an early T-Bird?
I usually do a good job of saving my lives, and so I know I can take a death, maybe, or... And then... Yeah, I hate the drops that bring you back all the way to the beginning, you know?
Yeah, they're lots of fun, that's for sure. As Dark Magician does finally locate the item room. Grab that Water of Life. Has to go back to Mido still as well, so...
Yeah. Means sometimes I'll up A and then just get a full complement of lives back, and I'm ready for exploring.
Yeah, that is the nice thing about an early Thunderbird. If you do take a death, like, he had to because he cast Thunder off screen. It is a time loss, but it is still something where having the extra life and full resources can be nice.
He has his magic back.
But yeah, he does get his magic back here, and gonna go ahead and just keep on trucking. Ooh, fairy room. I'd be getting fairy queued up if I were him. I always fall on this stupid right. Room.
I know, yeah.
But he doesn't. He makes it through expertly.
Your feet are basically touching the fire. You can't even cast fairy.
Yeah, that's true. It's, you do it at the beginning or you don't at all.
Bots everywhere. The goddamn level designers at Nintendo.
Well, and like the best part is that you're used to killing them in one hit, and you get to GP, and they don't die in one hit anymore, so you think you're gonna kill it, and you run into them and die anyways. So Thunder here for Dark Magician. We'll see how much longer it takes him to get over to GP.
He must be a finally. Not sure if he checks IRC, but when he sees probably typing done, he's gonna be so disappointed.
Yeah, I mean, at this point, you gotta be looking for it at any given time. And here's the Eon drop. Will he take it?
Yeah.
He's gonna.
Yeah, he will.
Alright, so...
Taking the drop, I take it, you know? But going right in the drop, it's always like, well, how far out? And then he's looping back.
Yeah, and it's a 4.5 minute time difference here, so we'll see if Dark Magician can make it up. Yeah, that does loop, so you have to go left at the Eon drop.
I hate when it loops you left of the starting elevator. Starting elevator, you know? Area or something. I had to make one joke about Angry Larry before at the end of the comment, you know?
Why stop at one?
So that drop,
man. There's Dark Link.
Was not the Eon drop. He went up at the fairy room, right?
Right, yeah, you're right. He went up at the fairy room. So,
room that was the bridge.
Yeah, so I mean, you got to imagine that if Dark Magician hadn't spent so much time looking for that cave, that this could have really come down to the fact that one went up and one went down after T-Bird.
This is such a good game to Rose City Saint for sure. This is such like, I get such a down when I see people are done when I'm beating T-Bird, you know, like probably what's going through Dark Magician's mind. It's such a bad feeling because you're almost there.
Yeah.
You know, and it happened twice to me in tournaments, and I think the first time I took a death to T-Bird because I was in shock, and I was like, ugh. You know you're almost there. You know, if you were that close, then it all comes down to a mistake that you made, and you start, you know, what could I have done better, and...
And Lava Bath for Dark Magician. Man, ropes are just horrible. not blockable. And, yeah, again, like you were saying, you're so close to the lava that it just doesn't matter. So will he go up? He'll go down. So he would have made this the same loop here that Rose City Saint's gonna make. Yeah.
Are you going to invite Rose City Saint to in chat?
Yeah. If you want to interview him real quick, I actually need to AFK for a moment. But then I'll be right back and we'll get set up for the next race.
Ask him where he bought that nice leather chair he's got. Dark Magician's almost there, and he's probably gonna take loop back to right before T-Bird. Then I'm hoping he's not going to go back to the drop. I think he's going to go up at the ferry elevator. A fun room. Let's bust under it here. But he's probably realizing now that he just looped back. He's going to cast a life spell. Please. Good, you know, always good to see players finishing their races. When you're that close, there's no need to forfeit, of course. Sometimes you just want to see how close you were and... joining, he still hasn't joined. And we have Dark Magicians at Darklink. Dark Magician choosing to beat Darkling the old-fashioned way. As you'd expect from Dark Magician at this point. About it. I know Choke says the old-fashioned way. I actually didn't know about the cheesy way of... always went old-fashioned on him. I went with jump strats. The first time I saw using the side strat, it was in speedruns. Yeah, I believe we have probably Rose City Saint. People beat Darklink using the side strat that was in speedruns. If I can fairly recently. I believe we have probably Rose City Saint.
Hello?
Hello.
This is Rose City Saint?
Yeah, this is Rose City Saint. What's going on?
Hey, man, how you doing? This is Cool in the Gank.
Oh, cool. Good to talk to you.
Close race, as you'd expect,
Hello?
Right? I think you guys are on Rose City Saint. Similar.
Yeah, this is Rose City Saint. What's going on?
Hey man, how you doing? This similar is, types cool of skills. And,
oh, cool. Good
you,
to talk
you
to you.
Really, it was a really close thing, even despite all the searching you guys had
close
to do for
race, as you'd expect, right?
Spell item and fire on similar.
Well, yeah. Yeah, first of all, the Dark Magician is a great opponent.
Similar types of skills and
raced him several times in SR.
Really, it was a really close thing.
We've beaten each
despite
other
all the searching
several
you guys
times,
had to
so
do for,
yeah, it was a good matchup.
The spell item in 5.
The whole thing there at the end was obviously was looking for the spell item. Magician is a great opponent. Raced him several
and
times in SRL.
I thought
we
completely
blew
each other
the game. If you saw me, I was
times,
kind of
so,
tooling
yeah,
around Palace 2, looking for it, and I got frustrated and gave up and left. And then as I progressed, I realized, boy, that was a pretty bad mistake.
I remember that. I think Dark Magician did spend a lot of time cave. When you guys got the hammer, you know, of course the hammer was like a big tease. It's like, oh my god, you have to go and get the spectacle rock and the hammer block cave, and that gave you nothing but a heart container and a pee bag. Dark Magician forgot where the hammer block cave was, and he lost a lot of time looking for it, and it probably made the game changer, really.
Oh yeah, that was really frustrating. When you get that hammer, you know, you want to make a beeline for those hammer blocks, and they were nothing but garbage. And then I told myself, well, you know, I got to go back for the water tile, and I think the spell tower was the other thing that I had to check. And I was really frustrated at that point. I was getting nothing but pee bags and heart containers, and I knew I had to narrow it down to a Palace 2 or Palace 5. And I said, well, I'm going to do a full clear of 5, because if the item I needed was in 2, I'm guaranteed to lose anyway. So I'm just really happy that that worked out in my favor.
So now you're 2 wins, and you know, congratulations, man. You're going to make at least the big raffle, the big race. And if you don't get a third win, then you know, you're really much more in contention than somebody like me who's 0-2.
Oh yeah, well, that's good. I put myself in a good position now. I would love to just win next week and not even be in that play-in game, but if I am, you know, that's cool too. We'll see what happens. Can't wait to see who I play next. It'll be someone who's pretty good, I'm sure. So
yeah, I'm not quite sure how the seeds work. If you're 2-1, are you facing someone who's 2-1? Is that what it is?
I believe so.
I'm hoping we're going to get
so
Dark
Magician
close,
right? He was right on me the whole time?
I think you were at different places, but, you know, like we had to take things into account. Well, he's beaten 6, and the Rose City Saint hasn't done that yet, but we knew it was going to be a close thing in the end, you know?
Oh, yeah, definitely.
How much backtracking you, the raft, you know, like you had to go back. How many times did you have to go back to the Western continent? Because first you got trophy, you had to cash that in, and you have to go back for the medicine, and then downstab. And
oh yeah, I thought for sure I was losing time. My personal thing was I went through Saria every time I needed to go back and forth between the northern and southern part of that continent, and there probably was a quicker way, but
oh, there
I just decided
it.
To
we checked
stick with it.
It's a, this was a Bagu required seed.
Was it really? Yeah, I had. I had Bagu, but I think I ferry just about every time. I think I only used Bagu the very first time.
Do after.
Thing too
you
was
ferry across the pound, right? Yeah, but that's the thing, though. Like, we checked, like, I loaded up the seed myself, and I checked Jump Cave didn't connect, Ferry Cave didn't connect. So, yeah, I or boots were needed to go up. But
well,
the
that's good
so
to know.
Far.
That's why I didn't lose as much time as I thought. I thought that Dark Magician probably had a better way to go back and forth, and I thought I was taking a slightly longer route. But my other concern with the seed was in Palace 6, I didn't have the jump spell. That's something you like to have not only to fight Barba, but I thought I was going to have to jump the Canadian hole without jump. With that floor tile set, that was going to be pretty difficult. That was an unfortunate floor to get in that palace. So I was really relieved when I took that first left and I saw that I came out on the other side of the Canadian hole.
Okay, yeah.
I lightened up at that point.
It's because you didn't get jump spell, right?
No, I never did. That I think it was trophy blocked, and it must have been in Palace too.
Yeah, no, that's it. It was trophy blocked, and trophy was in
P2.
P2, sorry.
I think 2 was the only item in the entire game I didn't get.
Gino said you were right. He was a little worried. He was a little worried about not having the jump spell to maybe close that hole and be.
I might have attempted several times.
It's always a worry for sure. It is a bit of a trek to get back there as well.
Yeah, definitely. I just got lucky today. I guess that's okay. When I played jam last week, the item I needed for Thunder was the very last place I could look, and he found it like in the first half hour, I guess. So that's just the way it goes sometimes.
Oh yeah, you got to roll with the punches. Scorpion Max says that boots, once you have the boots, there was a way to get up there without Bagu. Maybe he was playing the seed, and so I'll just take his word for it.
Yeah,
that's the way Dark Magician going, do it
around the right side.
I'll be honest, I didn't even realize I was going north. I thought the whole time I was traveling south. I was very confused about that. Otherwise, I probably would have tried to find a way that didn't involve Saria. But, you know, what are you going to do?
Yeah, yeah. Oh, yeah, for sure. I don't even know sometimes if it's north or south. I can't tell. I tried to keep track on the graph paper, and I sometimes get the north and south flipped down, you know?
Yeah, you just have to base it on the number of encounters that spawn. If you get two sets and you're in the south, if you only get one, then you're probably in the north, probably close enough to the north.
I could tell by the I think it's the water, it blocks the bottom of the south, and the mountains block the top or something.
I don't think it's consistent. It can be either way. But yeah, my only regret was not digging through five after I got a quick Guma, which this isn't the first time I've done it. So yeah, got to change that plan.
And you really blamed though because of how short it was.
Pardon?
It was bright pink. Palace 5 was this bright, disgusting pink.
Oh, I block out all colors whenever I play. I just play.
Dude, I actually found that like pretty difficult to work around. It was distracting.
Yeah, tiles and colors just disappear whenever I play. It's just sprites that I have to deal with.
I guess. I try to keep track of that stuff just so I have something to complain to dig about.
I will say that if there's one thing that costs Dark Magician would be not being able to find Trophy Cave after you'd found Hammer. That cost you a lot of time.
And I knew where it was. I knew it was in the south and top left corner near the swamp. And I swore I checked the cave before I went back up to the north to check. And I'm really upset with myself at that one.
Yeah,
I lost 3-4 minutes easily just... Yeah, on that one segment.
Yeah, it's all in the details, though. You guys were so close.
Yeah, and again, you guys 100% of the seed for the most part. Your times were fantastic. You both played phenomenally. It just came down to a couple of little things, like a lot of these races today have. But very well done by both of you. Congratulations to Rose City Saint. And I'm still scared for anybody that has to race you.
I appreciate it, and thank you for the restreams too.
Yeah, no problem.
Yeah. And with that, I'm going to duck out so you can get the next race going. So, all right. Take care.
Yeah, I think we've got...
Thanks, guys. Take care.
Yeah, thank you guys very much.